Hi everyone and welcome. In this review note, we are going to create a virtual machine in vSphere and install ESXi 6.5 as the guest operating system. Right click on my resource pool, select the new virtual machine wizard. We're going to create a new virtual machine, give it a name. The compute resource is going to be my resource pool, which is fine. Storage is going to be my data store, which is also fine. We're going to keep the latest version of hardware. For the guest operating system, we'll select other, and then from the dropdown, we'll pick ESXi 6.5 or later. And there's a number of different things we have to do here in the virtual hardware. One, we need a minimum of two virtual CPUs. I'll expand that out. Also inside the CPU, some other configuration changes we have to make. One is that we have to expose hardware-assisted virtualization. If we don't do that, we will not be able to run any guest operating systems inside of our virtualized virtual host. We should also enable virtual CPU performance counters if we want to be able to measure some of the performance. Also, notice that this is set up so that there's one core per socket and two sockets, which is going to give us a little bit better performance than if we go the other way around, because it'll simulate hyperthreading under those circumstances. Going to change my memory from 4 to 6 gigabytes. My hard disk size of 40 gigabytes is fine. I am going to expand this out though and change it from thick to thin provisioned, which we typically do in a virtual environment. I'm going to get rid of the floppy drive because I don't need that. We currently have one network adapter which is connected to my 01 port group. We actually need 4 network adapters to complete our labs. I'll say that I want to work with a network device, and I'll add 3 times. We see the additional network adapters down at the bottom. The first and the second are fine being left on the 01 port group. I want the third one to be on port group 2, and the last one to be on port group 3. Last thing I need to do here is mount the ISO, or should say point to the ISO, for ESXi 6.5 so that it will actually have something to boot from and load. So I'll choose the ISO's data store. I'll choose the ESXi installer ISO. Say OK. Expand out my optical disk and click connect at power on. And I am now good to go with that. Click next and finish. And our VM will now be created. Here it is here. I can power this up. And we'll open the console so that we can monitor what's going on. We'll watch this boot up for a couple of minutes until it starts prompting us for information that we have to put in to complete the installation. Right, so once booted up, we have to press enter to continue the installation. F11 will accept the license agreement. Once the scan is finished, we'll be presented with the storage that we have available. Press enter to continue. US keyboard layout. Put in our password for the root account. And once the system is finished scanning, it will allow us to install, for which we have to press F11. And now it's a matter of waiting for the system to install and come back to the console screen, ready for post-installation configuration. Eventually, we'll get to the point where we're prompted to reboot. Just press enter. The system will go through the reboot process, and when that is done, we should be successfully set to the console screen where we can start our post-installation configuration. And if all goes according to Hoyle, once the system's rebooted, it will present us with a console screen that looks basically like this. That's a wrap for the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.